Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about cerebellum. It is also called as little brain. In this picture we can see the cerebellum which presents behind the pons and under the cerebrum. The main role of the cerebellum is to maintain the tone of the muscles, the equilibrium and posture of the body, and also the body movements which is controlled by the cerebellum. So coming to the structure of the cerebellum is located at inferior to the occipital and the temporal lobes, and also present at the posterior cranial fossa. There are two hemispheres, right and left, which controls the ipsilateral side of the body. Ipsilateral is nothing but the same side of the body. The right hemisphere controls the right side and the left hemisphere controls the left side. Whereas in the cerebrum, you can see the contralateral control of the cerebrum over the body. So in cerebellum, either directly or indirectly through other parts of the brain, the cerebellum controls the body movements. The two hemispheres are connected centrally by a median, a vermis. So there are two surfaces, the superior and inferior surfaces. The superior surface has a convex and a continuous in nature, and the inferior surface have a deep median notch in the center, which is called as valicula, which divides the hemisphere into two, that means right and left. So what are all the lobes present in the cerebellum, or the anterior lobe, middle lobe and the floculonodular lobe? The anterior lobe and the middle lobe, which divided or separated by the primary fissure. The middle lobe and a nodular lobe, which is separated by a fissure called a posterolateral fissure. So coming to these pictures, you can see the vermis is present centrally. There are fissures, you can see here. This one is the fissure, this is the primary fissure, and this is one is the posterolateral fissure. You can see the lateral hemisphere, the intermediate zones, and the intermediate zone here and here. This was the lateral hemisphere, this was the posterolateral fissure, this is the anterior lobe, this is the posterior lobe, and the below one is the floculonodular lobe. In the lateral view, you can clearly see the primary fissure and the posterolateral fissure, which separates the middle lobe and the floculonodular lobe. This was the posterolateral fissure, which separates the middle lobe and floculonodular lobe. In this, we can see some additional fissure, preculminate and intraculminate for the anterior lobe. Superior, posterior, ansoparamedian, intrabiventral and secondary for the posterior lobes. So what are all the subdivisions and functional divisions of the cerebellum? Previously we have seen the anatomical divisions of the cerebellum. Here we can see the functional or a physiological divisions of the cerebellum. The vermis contain the lingula, a central lobule, the culmen, declive, folium, tuber, pyramids, uvula and a nodule, and there are some subdivisions of the cerebellar hemispheres at the each anterior, posterior or floccular nodular lobes. So here we can see the spinocerebellum, corticocerebellum and vestibular cerebellum. We can see it detail in the next slides. So the functional zones of the cerebellum, the main functional zones are the vermis, intermediate zone, lateral zone and the floculonodular lobe. So what is spinocerebellum? Spinocerebellum is nothing but the sum up of the vermis and intermediate zones. So cerebrocerebellum is the, which is also called as the lateral zone, or the lateral zone is also called as the cerebrocerebellum. So the floculonodular lobe, which is functionally called as the vestibulocerebellum. Coming to the zones and its function. So the spinocerebellum contains two parts. One is the vermis and intermediate zone. The vermis controls the axial muscles. The intermediate zone controls the muscles of the hand, finger and feet and toes. So the spinocerebellum controls the center of the body, the axial muscles. The intermediate zone controls the periphery of the body, the hand, finger and feet and toes. The cerebrocerebellum. The cerebrocerebellum is also called as a lateral zone, which involved in planning and programming the muscular activities. Which involves in planning and programming the muscular activities with association areas of the cerebral cortex. It helps the cerebral cortex to control and involve in the planning and programming the activities of the muscles. So, coming to the functions of the vestibular cerebellum or the flocculonodular lobe, it maintains the equilibrium with the help of the next. So, coming to the layers of the cerebellum, there are two layers. One is the outer gray matter and the inner white matter. The outer gray matter contains some layers. First layer is the outer molecular or reflexiform layer. The second one is the intermediate Purkinje layer. The third one is the inner granular layer. So what comes under the inner white matter? The inner white matter contains some afferent and efferent fibers, which is classified into association fibers, commissural fibers and projection fibers. The projection fibers also divided into three, which is called as cerebellar bundle. The projection fibers which divided into inferior cerebellar bundle, middle cerebellar bundle and superior cerebellar bundle. So next we are deal about cerebellar nuclei. There are four important nucleus which presents in the cerebellum is the vestigial nuclei, the globose nuclei, the emboliform nuclei and the dentate nuclei. So here in this picture you can see the vestigial, the globose, the emboliform and the dentate nucleus. So these nuclei are very important in the controlling the movements, everything which is very important for the movements. Coming to the layers of the cerebellum, this one is the molecular layer, this one is the Purkinje cell layer and this is the granular layer. Below one is the white matter. So in the molecular layer and all this layer, we have some cells present in each and every layers. So what are all these cells? So in the molecular layer we have two cells. One is the stellate cells and other one is the basket cell. In the Purkinje cell layer, the name itself is a self-explanatory. It has Purkinje cells. In the granular layer, we have three cells. One is the Golgi cell, another one is the glomerulus, and another one is the granule cells. There are two fibers we have to see here. One is the climbing fiber from the medulla, and another one is the mossy fibers. The mossy fibers is look like a plant moss, so it called as the mossy fiber. So moss means like a bush. In this view, I have show some spiral lines. I want to represent it as dendrites, and one long line to represent the axons. This was the axons, this is the axons, and these are all the dendrites. So this is the connection which presents inside the cerebellum. So when the signals coming from the climbing fibers and the mossy fibers, there are some stimulation or the excitation which presents at the Purkinje cells and also at the granule cells. So when this excitation happens, the granule cells which send the parallel fibers to the molecular layer, which excites all the cells of the molecular layer like Purkinje cells, stellate cells, basket cells, etc. This is the only cell of the cerebellum which excites while on excitation. So everything except it inhibit whatever it ends up. So the stellate cells inhibit the Purkinje cells, the basket cells inhibit the Purkinje cells and everything. The Golgi cells also inhibiting the glomerulus. So this was the primary structure, the excitation and inhibition principles of these cells. While we can see these structures, these basic structures help to tune the circuit of the movements. If we want to flex our elbow, the cerebrum, which gives the information to the cerebellum to tune what are the range we want, the cerebellum will tune the circuit and tune the muscles, and maintaining the tone, this circuit help to maintain the tone and maintain the equilibrium via the cerebellar nuclei that we have previously seen, the four nucleus. Via the cerebellar nuclei, we can control the whole body movements. So coming to the white matter of the cerebellum, so representing the two cerebellar hemispheres, so this one is the association fibers which present and connects the same side hemispheres front and back. The commissural fibers which connects the both hemisphere from right to left and left to right. So in this view, this is the brainstem and this is the cerebellum. We can see some peduncles, middle peduncle, superior cerebellar peduncle, inferior cerebellar peduncles. So what are the function of the peduncle? The superior cerebellar peduncle is also called brachia conjunctiva, which predominantly the efferent fibers is sending signals to the midbrain. The middle fiber, middle cerebellar peduncle, is also called as a brachiopontis, which is afferent in nature. It is mainly having commissural fibers which connect the both hemispheres. The inferior cerebellar peduncles is also called as the restiform bodies. It also afferent in nature. From the tactile proprioceptors and vestibular apparatus, it giving signal to the brainstem as well as the cerebellum. Thank you.